What's up, everybody? Back here with Rock, Dome of the Rock, None and All Now, YouTube. Today, we are going to have another King's Academy. And today's King's Academy is actually our God 300 level class. We're talking about further proofs for the existence of God. For those of you who do not like the comprehensive anthropological approach, well, we are going to take a second comprehensive anthropological approach through the lens of poetry. Except this ain't going to be no poem, baby. This is going to be one long spoken, open word. And you are going to love it. Let me tell you something. Folks, today I have notes. This is the first time here at None and All Now. I have been live one time, every time up until this point, improvising and simply trying to get it all at once. But today, I have a script, so you're going to enjoy it. All right, now, this is called Further Proofs for the Existence of God. For those of you who are interested in proving or possibly, hey, I'm giving you guys ammo here. Disproving the existence of God, but I'm going to be arguing in the affirmative according to this. All right. Well, first of all, let's start with what God is not, because let me tell you something. This is directed really, this talk is really directed to all the atheists out there. I love you atheists. You guys are thinking. That is great. I love it. You rebelled against the church. That is wonderful. I salute you and applaud you for leading that revolution against ignorance and hatred and stupidity. Oh, man. But that's great. Those of you who got stuck on atheism, this is for you. This is what God is not. God is not a white dude riding on a cloud who's an asshole, but he loves you. He can see you all. He cares about each one of you, every one of you, very, 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 very personally and distinctly. He's not a he. God is not a person. He's not an anthropomorphism. It is not any of those things that you have rebelled against. God is not what people in this country are stereotypically assumed to say it is. It's nice that atheism is designed as a reactionary thing against that. Say, hey, God is not that thing. However, atheists have gone farther than just to say God is not that thing. They have gone so far to argue in the affirmative that there is no such thing as something called God. Well, this is obviously foolishness, nonsense. It's such a ridiculous argument that the premise of it, right at the very beginning, is absolutely stupid. If you are arguing that something you do not believe to exist in the first place does not exist in the first place, you are a fool. Well, I'm going to go with you guys here, and I'm going to say, hey, let's start with what God is. And we're going to say God is something that all atheists can agree with. I think every atheist who will ever watch this video can agree with me that God is nothing. Nothing. First and foremost, God is nothing. That is a fucking truth that most religious people have not studied yet enough to get to, and that any atheist, just because of their own sheer ignorance and liking of that way that thing sounds and rings in their ears, oh, they're going to say to themselves, that sounds like the truth to me. God is nothing. I believe in nothing. And is nothing something? That's a question that scientists are trying to prove. But today, now, scientists are starting to realize that, whoa, the universe is made up of empty space, nothing, dark matter, negative space, negative energy, black holes and things. Oh, God may be nothing, and nothing may be something, and then we'd all be in trouble then, huh? Because we wouldn't be able to be atheists anymore. We'd have to be nihilists? Oh, no. Stay with me here, folks. Kabbalism rhythm. God is a word. Oh, God is a word. It's an English word. It's a G-O-D word. And there are a lot of other names and words for this. Now, it just so happens that the G-O-D word in God is interchangeable for gods and the big God, the God above the gods. Some religions, some languages, some cultures have words to distinguish between them. I'm talking about two different gods right now. One is the gods that are rumored to appear in human form and be like, "Ooh, shake up the world, baby, bringing you secret fire down from the heavens." But other ones are the big God, the big nothing God, the big zero God, the big God, the big universal God. Oh, shit. God is a word to describe that thing. The other words that we use to describe that thing are Allah and Brahma. So we have to distinguish, of course, whether we're talking about the Allah Brahma or are we talking about some other kind of God there. Because if the God takes any kind of form anthropomorphically, it can no longer be the Allah Brahma. It must be the Atman, the God that takes form. And Muslims don't acknowledge such things. Only Hindus do. And most Christians don't know they're actually Hindu. But, oh well. Anyways, moving forward. God is a word. And the word exists. So if it's a word and you use it, like I said, it must exist. So you can't argue in the affirmative that it does not exist. You can't argue that you do not like it. You can't argue that you think it's useless. You can't argue that you think it's unfashionable. You can argue that you think it's backwards. You can argue that you think it's outdated. You can argue that you think it is ugly and nasty and that you don't want to have anything to do with it. You can argue all of those things. But you cannot argue that God is not a word. For it is a word. And it exists as a word. Just as all words exist. And you would not argue that language and words do not exist, would you? Okay, so let's move forward. God is a concept. God is a concept. God is a concept. What kind of a concept is God? We are going to explore that further, but God is a concept, and that is something that you must understand. And if you cannot understand that God is a concept, you are obviously off your ability to understand conceptual ideas. Now, I don't know any atheists who have said, "Hey, I'm going to abandon anything that is not conceptual. If I cannot measure it discreetly in life, time, space, if I can't find it, if it isn't there, if I can't anthropomorphize it and find the actual being behind it, I don't care, I'm not going to be interested in that, that's a stupid idea." But most of you still follow things like politics and democracy and ideas like freedom and justice and even money. Oh. And all of those things are made up things. They don't exist. They can't find them in the world. They're just abstractions. Arbitrary abstractions. Meaningless value points put on things by people. They have nothing to do with anything. They don't even exist at all. Unless you all agree to have them as part of your life and let them affect your social understanding, none of those things are real. Oh, well, God is a concept. God is a concept that is very real. It affects people. You can argue that that concept does not exist, but it does. And you're kind of a fool if you do. Now, moving forward. There is a concept that says that God is the total package of the universe, and that is what Allah Brahma is rumored to be. Allah Brahma is the entire universal reality, conscious and aware of itself. Oh, that is the big nothing behind everything. The big empty thing that keeps pouring out more and more and more. And also influences everything that happens. Keeps changing things all the time. Throwing things in front of you left and right. It is always working. Things on track. Woo, woo, woo. Hey, God is the universe. God is little balls going around in circles. God is all of these things. God is the things that we are looking at with the telescopes and all the astronomers and everything Stephen Hawking and Carl Sagan and all of these wonderful scientific people who are looking out into space and thinking, "My God, this is the cosmology is wonderful. It's making me think about all these wonderful things. I love it. It looks wonderful." That is God. That is the universe. The universe is God. Whether you think it's conscious or not, everything that happens in the universe is God. So if you think that God is not consciousness, and you say to yourself, the universe is not conscious, and I'm not going to have the universe be God and conscious at the same time. Fine. Say that God is just the total universal presence, the total presence of everything at any given moment in the entire universe. That is the God. That is the God. That is the God, and that is Allah, and that is Brahma. It is all the spiritual things that happening in the universe. That is how some people look at it. You don't need to look at it that way. You can say, hey, I'm going to look at it some other way. I don't like spiritual things because they don't make any sense to me. I don't understand that. I can't measure it. I don't want to know. Well, maybe you want to know about immutable laws, okay? You're going to say, God is things that are like, electromagnetics, gravity, little balls going in circles. God is balance. God is ever springing forward. God is the nature of the universe that is constantly expanding and constantly getting smaller and smaller and smaller and breathing and flexing and hinging and moving back and forth. How come God can be all those things? How come God can be the pattern repeaters? You know, the things that are going around and around and around, the circles on our brains, you know? We are looking out at this universe, and that is all we can see and all we can find. All of this curvature and empty space and things coming back to us, and all of these things are giving us ideas about the presence of existence, and these are the immutable laws of cosmology. And why can't God be those? Are you going to argue that those do not exist as well? Are you going to argue that my definition of God is not good enough for you and that my God does not exist because you do not like it? Oh, I'm going to keep arguing for God because we're going to find another way to think about God. God is the creator. Oh, you don't like that version. I know that. Because you don't like the idea that some being created the universe, especially some anthropomorphic being who is sliding on a cloud and waves his hand, and all of a sudden all of the universe comes into existence. This is a stupid idea. Yes, it is. However, for a child, the mother is God, right? Because she is the one who created the child. If we are not even asking ourselves, where is God and what is God? What are we saying about the creator? The mother created the child, right? So if the mother creates the child, who creates the mother? This goes on and on and on. And back into the beginning of the universe, somebody created something first, right? Everything that we have had to be created out of something somewhere. If you find a leaf on the ground, it was created by a tree. If you find anything in this universe, it was created by something. If you find rocks, they were created by pressure and carbon and all of these other things. Well, what created all of those things? We don't know. Maybe we think they are just sitting there all the time without creation at all. But for as far as we can tell, certainly some things in this universe are created. And when we are talking about life, life creates more life. So who created the life? We don't know. We don't know. But life is something that we are exerting and we are experiencing, and we are going through the existence of life, and it is happening to us here on Earth. And there are people who have gone through this life here on this earth, and they have decided that their God is the earth itself, because that is the celestial body upon which they are part. They are riding on this living cell that is floating in the universe, going around and around and around the sun, and they are moving at whatever, how many things that they are thinking about. Wherever things are growing, they are there. They are on Earth. They are part of this planet. All of the things that they have seen and experienced are the Earthlings, the human beings, the people who are here. That is the God. God is the Earth itself. God is this planet and everything that is its totality. But some people are going to say, no, I don't like that idea of God. But they are not going to argue that it does not exist. They are not going to argue that it does not exist. And so, we have found so many things that God may be that you think are not existing and that you don't like the idea of. One more, nature. Oh, so many people don't like the idea of God is nature. But God is nature. God is the nature all around us that bore us and feeds us and sustains us and has brought us to where we are now. And now we are killing that nature and the world is going to shit in front of our eyes. because we have killed our own gods. Oh, we have destroyed the thing that has brought us all this bounty and wonderfulness in the first place. And now everybody who enjoys the outdoors and trees and wildlife and animals and plants and rain and weather and all of these different things, they don't have it. All you have is concrete and wire and wood and stone and electricity and police and war and guns and stuff that sucks. So you killed your nature, and now you don't have a god anymore. Oh, I'm so sorry for you. Oh, look, goddess energy. Fucking, the universe is made of energy. Your science has told you that. They are trying to tell you that all the time, that everything is made of energy. Well, if everything is made of energy, and energy is the source of all life in the world, then God must be energy. And do you know that is exactly what people thought God was when they were back in the very beginning of the world, when the people were still young and they didn't know anything yet? They look up into the sky and they say, the sun is what makes everything grow and make me warm. It will give me food. It's what I need to dry meat. Everything to me is the sun, the sun, the sun, the sun and the moon, the sun and the moon. They're looking into the heavens and they're saying to themselves, man, that big floating ball of fire up there is fucking great. I love it. It's my God. Well, God is energy. And some people, God is the sun. For me, God is the sun. I love the sun. I love it. I love it. But for some people, they say, hey, no, man, God is light. God is light. Okay, God is light. God is spectral light. God is light when it's been separated by a prism. It's a rainbow. Oh, I like that idea very much. It's very good. But you're not going to argue that spectral light and rainbows don't exist. You're just going to say, oh, you can't argue that God is that way because the only thing I can fucking see God as is the stupidest thing that God is not, right? I only want to take the worst Christian ideas of God and say the worst ideas that these people have. This guy in the sky. This guy is not the God. This red-headed, long-haired, bearded guy wearing rags, talking shit, hanging on everybody because he loves them. This is not the God. This is not the God. All right, fine, this is not the God. God is light, but you don't like that. You say this only the other thing. Fine, I'm saying God is light. God is light. God is light. And you're not going to argue that light does not exist, and you're not going to argue that you understand light. So you can't really argue that God is not light, because you don't even know what light is. Oh, there is something else you do not understand, because science cannot explain it, but it is love, love, love. And yes, science can say that love is just chemicals in the brain. But then again, science doesn't really know what that is. And they don't know how it affects people, and they don't know why people will do different things or why love will take you in other places. How it works, how you maintain it, exactly what it means in the world. Because if it all just came down to chemical equations in the brain, it would be very simple and there wouldn't be anything else, and that would be stupid. So obviously love is much more than just chemical equations in the brain. People have to work together, they have to get along, they have to make concessions, they have to struggle and they have to fight and they have to stick by it and they have to stay there and make it happen. And it hurts and it's painful and it takes a long time and everybody knows what it feels like and everybody wants it. But science does not understand it. Only people who are seeking it and using it and studying it and experiencing it understand it. And science can't do that, because science is not equipped with that kind of logic. Well, anyways, some people say God is love, God is light. Oh, that's so nice. Moving on. We've already said that you don't want me to say this, that God is consciousness, because you say everything that's only conscious has to have a brain, and so only people are conscious, even though we're scientific facts to show you that plants are conscious too, and plants don't necessarily have brains. Now, you're going to say plants do have brains. They are going to find things that are making the brains of plants inside of the, you know, the cellulose, the plant matter, the skins of the plants. There's some kind of brain in there. The DNA is some kind of brain. So then you're going to say rocks don't have brains, except rocks exhibit some kind of luminescence and energy all the time. And so you're going to say, well, that's not the same thing as consciousness. That's, radiation is not consciousness. You're going to say nothing is alive, this and that. You're going to say you're the only ones who are consciousness. So saying that God is consciousness is not good enough, right? Well, if you read the Bible, it's good enough, because where is the one verse in the Bible where they explain what God really is? This Bible is like Exodus 3:15, right? I think that's what it is. I'm not sure for sure. But it is the one where God says to Moses from the bush, I am that I am. It's also in capital letters for a reason. Because I am consciousness. I am consciousness. I am consciousness. You say that you were made in the image of God, and you think that that makes you anthropomorphically like God, like God is a human being just like you. No. You were made in the image of God, that you were given I am consciousness. God is an I am consciousness. God is consciousness, consciousness, consciousness. If the universe, the big nothing at the top of everything is conscious, then that is Allah, that is Brahma, and that thing exists, and consciousness is the fucking primary ground for everything else in the universe, then you can't say God does not exist. And you say, oh, well, we can't test consciousness, so we don't know if it's there. And you have it, but you don't know if it's there. Who are you to test anything? Let's move on. Ego! Oh, did I hurt your egos? Oh, well, that's not what ego means, because you were thinking that ego just means, like, whether you have feelings only for yourself, it's selfishness, it's overconfidence, it's being too much of an asshole all the time. Well, no, that is not ego exactly. Ego is self-awareness, which is just like consciousness, except you don't understand that self-awareness and consciousness are the same thing. Now, some behavioral scientists and neuroscientists and other people who study cosmology and they want to know things about consciousness, especially, they are starting to realize that there is something about self-awareness creates consciousness, and that self-awareness repeats itself at every level of the universe. So you are self-aware as an entire human being, but also all of your cells and all of your organs and all of those things are self-aware as well. Oh my God. You guys don't understand consciousness at all. Everything in the universe is conscious, and if you don't understand that, you don't understand self-awareness, you don't understand ego. You are stuck on intelligence and having a brain, and that's fine. Some people will say that. They will say, okay, fine, God is consciousness. God is consciousness that has intelligence. God is consciousness with a brain. God is consciousness that can be directed and derived somewhere. God is our ability to think. If God is our ability to think, how can you remove its existence by using it? That is a good question for all you atheists out there. But you will say God is not our ability to think. I don't like that. Definition of God. Except there are millions of people using it, so I'm sorry. Okay, now God is the highest potential good of the human experience. Oh, people use this one as well. People believe that God is the most capableness of us. What we are headed for in a absolutely about to be able to do with ourselves. All of the technologies and things, all of the math, all of the language, all of the culture, everything we have built, all that is humanity, all that is anthropology, that is God. And I like that definition very much. I think people, if they invented God as some kind of social construct to get some kind of job done, it's just a fucking conceptual vehicle, as we have discussed. Oh, but you don't believe in conceptual vehicles like God, just other ones like education and science, whatever. Anyways, so God is going to be the highest potential good of the human experience, the total package of humanity that is working for something better, something brighter, something bigger, something more wonderful for all the people of the human race. You say that is God. No, that's not God. Okay, God is logic. God is our ability to process things and analyze them across each other. God is our ability to love logos. That is what we receive from the I Am. Okay? That is what the scriptures say, that the logos descends upon us because of the I Am consciousness, and because the highest level of the I Am consciousness, the highest level of the self-awareness, the highest level of being is the one that can process everything and change things around for themselves. The absolutely recognized being who can take in information, process it, and put it back out. Oh, God is logic and reason. God is logic and reason. But you don't like that idea, huh? You don't like the idea of it being the God. Okay, just throw the word God out entirely. Then you won't have atheism anymore, because it won't exist. Well, then you won't have no reason to hate God. But then I will say God is reason, and then you will have a reason to hate reason. Oh, God is a symbol, as I am a symbol, as this circle around my head is a symbol, as the Tai Chi in the corner is a symbol. I look the wrong way because I don't know left from right when I'm looking in a mirror. The Tai Chi is over here. That is a symbol to you. I'm an idiot. Oh, now you have an excuse. You can just say, hey, that guy's an idiot and I don't want to believe anything he says. That's why I don't have to listen to his argument. Okay, good symbol for you. There is a sign. All of these symbols you have created, all of your alphabetic symbols, the A, the V, the Z, I, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all these things you have. You have created them. You are using them. They're symbols. They're creating all kinds of feelings and things in your entire world. You're using them. They're there. They have power. But you do not believe. You do not believe in any of these things. So you're going to say, well, no, those are just symbols. God is not a symbol. But to a Christian, the cross is a symbol of God. You will say, no, it's backwards. Just because they're Christian and just because they have it all in reverse. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's good science. I really like that. That shows you're using your reason and your logic and your critical thinking skills. Real analytical. Your rhetoric is smashing. Moving on. Communication. Oh, am I being rude? Am I being sarcastic? Am I saying things beyond just like this and that? Is God our ability to have complex, fucking dynamic, communicative, fucking response, prod, movement, culture, language, all of these things, everything that results from us, the art, the poetry, the love, the preaching, the fucking sermons, everything you see, everything you hear, everything you feel, all the stories, all the myths, all the fucking tales, all the campfires and the things that we've set around them for the beginning of time since we had our first voice boxes. That is God. Why not? Why isn't the ability to fucking go beyond what animals can't even do, God, huh? Why isn't that way? God is the Word. That is one of the very first things the Bible says, that God is the Word. I already said that. God is a Word. You don't believe in God. How do you use words? Oh my God. I can't believe it. Most of you who don't believe in God, you will still say, oh my God. Jesus Christ. What a stupid thing to say if you don't believe in it. Ay, ay, ay. So, God is knowing things. When we are able to use our logic and our reason and our symbols and communicate them, other people will say, yes, I agree with that. That's very good. That's very smart. I think that's very, 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 very intelligent thing to say. I agree. Therefore, we know it. Once two people ratify, three people ratify, four people ratify, it's peer reviewed. Oh my goodness. We're in the discourse now. We are on the ivory tower. We know everything. We can say that we know these things because we have math. God is math. I mean, some people are going to say, yeah, dude, I like math, but you are tainting it by associating it with God. Because God cannot be math. Math is math, and God is not math. God is something else that does not exist. I like math. Math exists. You're saying all these things right now. I know you are. Come on. God is math. If you knew the history of math, if you knew where math started, if you knew where the beginning of math was, you would know that math was God for the people who began it in the beginning. They were looking at the monad. They were looking at the zero. They were looking at the perfect circle. They were looking at these calculations. They were looking at the immutable laws of the universe. One and 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 one. Around and around and around and around. And that's what they were doing. They were saying, oh, we're going to count this stuff up and we're going to start to play with that and we're going to figure things out. And that's going to make us powerful. That's going to make us omniscient. That's going to make us all knowing. That's going to give us power over our enemies. That's going to give us power over the people around us. And oh, so they used it and they said it was God and they put it out like that. Pythagoreanism. God is math. You don't believe it. Read a book. All right. God is science. Now I have a friend. He's a scientismist. This video is actually just for him. He's such a foolish guy. He thinks that God does not exist. And I'm trying to prove to him that he's wrong. But He believes that God is science, but he does not believe that it's God. Science is science to him, and science is all-knowing, it's omniscient, it's all-powerful, it's going to fix everything for all people everywhere. Science is the best thing we have. So he doesn't believe that God is science. He's not going to agree with me that other people agree with me. He is going to say, I don't agree with them, so it doesn't exist. So even though he places science at the fucking highest power in the universe, basically, all right? The highest potential good of humankind, the highest expression of our communication, our logic, our reasoning, our symbols. He's saying, hey, science is the best, math is so cool, I love it, I'm such a nerd. But he doesn't believe that that is the higher power. He doesn't believe that that is what divines for us. That is God. It is your God. Science is your God. But you do not believe that God exists, yet you do believe that science exists. Your observation of facts is absolutely stunning. Let's move on. God is evolution. God is the movement of everything through the universe. God is the path that it takes. God is the branching out the tree. God, if best expressed in form of something on the universe, is the giant Sonoma oak and winter. The tree of evolution, the tree of life, the movement of the spinal column into the body, the way a freeway feeds a city, the veins in a plant. God is the network. God is the internet. God is the evolution of our stuff. God is technology. God is science, and God is math, and God must be engineering too. That's why engineers think they're gods. That's why masonry is so cleverly guarded. It's such an important secret. They can't let all the math and the science get out. They have to make it really hard and put it in code so other people can't build their own houses. Because then they can't control you. Oh, you didn't know that. God is technology. God is the ability to reduplicate and create. God is the ability to put up light into fucking spectral form so that you can see pictures and images after they have been gone for long periods of time. God has the ability to record what is happening and reduplicate it in a fucking astral projection, just like you are using right now. God is technology, God is stuff, and you know that in the United States is the truth. God is stuff. We have so much fucking stuff here. People are living their whole lives for stuff. They are slaves to stuff. Everything they do in their lives is about more stuff. All we want to gather stuff, acquire stuff, 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 stuff. Stuff is going to make you happy. Stuff is your God. People don't think that it is, but it is. Oh, God is stuff. Oh, and stuff doesn't exist, I'm sure. Or it's just not God, I'm sure, right? Because it's the highest thing that we're shooting for. It's the one thing that we're all going, no, no, no. Everybody's zombieing along after more stuff. That's the highest thing in the fucking country. Let's all go get more stuff. Oh, wait, no, it's not stuff. It's money. The stuff we use to buy stuff. Don't lie. You know God is money. It says it right on it. It says God is money. Look, God is money. God is money. God is money. This is your God. This is your fucking God. This is your fucking God right here. You got it? Can't see it. It's no good. Bad lighting. Here, look. Here it is. This is your fucking God. Alright? The light God didn't like the money God, so I had to get the light God off the money God so that you could see the money God. You know what I'm saying? That's your God. People say, no, that's not my God. That's not my God. Yeah, right. You were all running around trying to get that, and you fucking know it. Don't try to lie. Everybody on this planet serves that right there. Everyone, except for the aesthetics and the bums and the people who don't even want it or can't figure out how to get it. The ultra poor are the only ones who have any excuse, and most of them are crying about that fucking blessing. Oh well, God is money, folks. God is money. Well, for those of you who are ultra poor, if you don't have any money, you might be saying, hey, I don't like that idea about God as money because I don't even want to go out and get no money. It's too hard to get money. Money sucks. It's crazy. It makes your life stressful. It ruins everything. It's destroying the earth. I don't even want stuff. I don't need a job. I don't need a career. I don't need a fucking TV. I don't even need a computer. I don't need to watch the dude on YouTube. You don't need stuff. You don't need technology. You don't need money. You don't need a car. You don't need more stuff. You got willpower. And that's what people around here got. They got willpower. You know, some freaking hippies living in the hills out here who are dirty, man. They ain't changed their clothes for months. Okay? These people don't even wash their hair. Well, guess what? We're out here, and we will show our will to you. And you can say, hey, God is not willpower. God is not the ability to eat less. God is not the ability to cut things out. God is not the ability to have thinking that goes against its own best interests in order to create best interests. God is not a paradox like that. Oh my God. Well, what do you think God is, man? Well, one way that people used to fucking express God is through art. Yeah. One of the very first expressions of God in human form was the little Venus figurine. And you know what? People who are artists of God images, of sacred artifacts, people who study how to, for example, make temples, buildings that remind you of God, they study God-like architecture. That's God art. When you make a church, you don't make it like any other building usually, right? The best churches are God architecture. They're architecture unlike anything else. It's not architecture that you would use for function or purpose. It's architecture that makes you feel something. Well, the same thing with any stone carving. Masonry, baby! When you starve, when you carve, when you get things out of stone and you work and you're mystical and you're crazy like that, you get art. People have been making art for years. In fact, the power of God is what has given people the ability to make bifacials and fucking arrowheads and hunting tools and spearheads and everything else after that. And the wheel. But y'all don't want to think about that because I got circles on my brain. I can tell. So God isn't art. You're going to say, no, art is art. Art is just something people do not to express any kind of like mystical energy in the universe to try to get things across that aren't necessarily understandable through math and ration and logic. Things that have to be expressed creatively with emotional content. You're going to say, hey, no, that's not art. That's not God. Those two things cannot be mixed together. You can't do that to me, dude. I don't like the idea that God and art would be mixed together. I know you atheists, you're thinking that right now. So you're thinking, hey, I want to keep my art and my God separate because I don't even like God to begin with, and art is still cool. All right, whatever, for sure. But there are other people in the world, Hindus especially. I'm back to Hinduism now. Let me tell you something. Hindus, they love their art in stone. They love their statues, their stone gods. It's called darshan, and the movement of making the statue, of making the stones, of making that art. Oh, baby, let me tell you something. That's what they live for. And the people who then go and see it, they think that those artisans have imbued so much love and focus into these things that they then become sacred artifacts by which you can contact the divine. Baby, that's what it is. It's called darshan. And that's how you worship when you're Hindu. You look at the fucking statue or the painting or whatever it is that represents the god, and then you're going to feel the god's energy through that thing because it's a sacred relationship. Oh, but you're going to say, no, 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 no. God is not statues, because you're going to say the same thing like the Muslims say or something like that. Say, you know, God can't be in any of those. And Allah cannot be in any of them. But the power of Allah, the remembrance of Allah, the focus of Allah can. That can. That can. And that's what the Hindus are saying with the darshan. And that's truth. But hey, truth to power. Don't say it. Hey, you want to know what makes power? State level power? Big ass statues. You make an obelisk like the one they got in Washington, D.C., and now you're the god. You got the power. You're the one who's in power. Some people say, if God's not a statue, what is a statue? Well, statue's power. And you know what some people will tell you? They'll tell you, hey, being in power is a little bit like being God. If you're God, you got the power, right? Some people, they think, hey, man, I have the power, therefore I am God. Obama! People have compared him to God since he's got the power. The President of the United States is like that guy. He can kill anybody. He can destroy anything. He can take the whole fucking world out if he wanted to. He makes all laws and hands down everything from on high. The guy's all powerful, all knowing, spies everywhere, sees everything. Oh, you are trimming in your boots. you don't want me to say that the President of the United States is God also, so I won't go there. But I'm saying the power of the state is like God, and that's what has been using God since the beginning of time to manipulate all you people and make you a bow face and walk around and do what it wants, but you ain't going to say that. So, hey, let's say that it gives you something. Let's say you get something out of it. Then God is the benefactor. God is the benefits of the state. God is the thing that you get from being in a big old social group. Oh, my God. There are some people that's what they use it for. That's what they use it for. That's why they go to church. That's why they are all together in a big social group, because it makes their life better. It gives them benefits like babysitters and people to have friends with and people who they know believe the same things as they do and act the same way they do and are safe to be around. They give them security and all these other things. Economy, it gives them something to trade with. It gives them something to do. It's a pluralistic society, baby. Oh, you don't want to believe that's God either. Okay. I can see God. God is not the benefactor that comes from your social relationships. And God is not the power of the state. God is not the state, period, right? The United States is not your God. Well, guess what? It's all powerful again. Like I said with Obama, oh, well, guess what it was before it was the United States? There was a time when it was the church. And guess what? For some people, it still is the church if they give their power. Like, you give your power to the United States, right? You say, hey, I vote. I'm part of this. I'm using their money. I'm signed on to their bullshit. That makes you guilty of everything that they do. And you're a benefactor of everything that they give you from that. Man, well, the church is the same way. Some people, they go there. They make friends. They get something to fucking eat. They get some power in them. They get psyched up. They go out in the next week and they're like, God is on my side. I got the church. I got friends. I got a pastor I can call. I can get my problems solved. I can fucking get something. If I need clothes, if I need friends, if I need a place to fucking get fired up so on Monday morning I'm ready to go out and get my ass a job. That's not God to you? Okay, fine. That's not God to you. It's not the state, it's not the church, it's not any of these things. I'll tell you what it is. God is your revolution. God is your revolution against God. You like to be saying that God is revolution. You could be, right? You think it would be cool? Because already the universe is going around and around and around and around. The world moving in revolution. You like the idea of revolution. Remember the revolutionaries, they said there is no God. And that's what all atheists are in the first place, right? They're all godless communists out there, right? Well, hey, God is communism too, but hey, don't get me started on what the purpose of religion is. Hey, all right, so God is the revolution. The revolution against God is atheism. Atheism is a God. Atheism is your religion. It is your revolution. Hey, I think that's great. Why do people do this stuff? Because they want to be in a part of an in-group, because they want to have some kind of stable identity that they can relate to so that they know who they are and they know what they are supposed to be doing in life and what it means to be them, so they can set themselves apart from everything else and have some kind of purpose and identity in the first place. God is identity. It's very close to I am, very close to self-awareness. Very close to the human experience when overlaid with all these things that I have just said before it. God is identity. Hey, I think people, that's why they say my God, your God, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Buddhist, Jew, Taoist. My God is this, your God is that. That gives us identity. Now we know who to fight. We know who to love. We know who we can marry. What's wrong with that? Doesn't exist? Okay, I'm sorry. All right, moving on. God is social glue. God holds us together. God is the justice for the people when that social glue is violated. God is justice. Do you know what the poor thing God is? You know what Jesus said so that the poor could feel better about God? You know what may be the case? If Jesus is God, if the world is the way that the poor people of Christianity say that it is, and Jesus really is a God, you know what God does? He gives people justice. You know how he does that? He hands out karma. You know how he does that? You get punished when you fuck up. Oh, and you know what he said that the justice of the poor is? It's hard when, if you're rich or, you know, you're motherfucking one of the guys who enables that. It's real hard. It's hard. It's hard to get through. It's hard to get through to the other side. It's hard to break on through to the other side. You need to be a long-haired freak. Or you need to be poor. You need to be a grandmother. Something like that. But if you're a big fat cat, getting everything you want, you don't care about nobody, you don't do nothing good for nobody, all you do is take and kill. Yeah, that's the justice. That's the justice. You meet me on the other side, and I escort you to your fucking cell. Oh, you're going to be butthurt about that, huh? Well, you don't want to believe in that, huh? Because if you're doing evil, you best want to believe in atheism. You best not think that I exist, because I'll be there when you coming over. Oh, wait, all right, justice is not a... That's not none of that's true. That's just a sow. That's just a crazy man talking to try to put the fear of God into some people because they punking everybody out, ruining the fucking earth, and destroying the fucking world for everybody. That's what that is. It's just a sow. It's just a way of making people feel better. Maybe that's what God is. God's a sow. It's a way of making people feel better, huh? We don't have that. It don't exist. Oh, okay. It don't exist. We don't have that. That's not what it is. I see how your argument just goes round and round and round. It's just a denial of everything we bring. I can see that. Except the problem is that everything I've said so far, there are other people who will ratify it. There are other people who will peer review it. There are other people who are going to say, no, that's all. That is all what God is. That is what God is. That is what God is. Oh, God is whatever we want it to be. Oh, what do you want it to be? You wanted it to be non-existent, except you wanted it to be non-existent. That's a non sequitur. That makes no fucking sense. How could you want something to be and then not want it to be? All right, well, God is what other people want it to be. So therefore, if they want it to be that, it exists to them. And if it exists in real life and they say, hey, that's it. For example, a Native American says, my God is the earth. You could say, no, it's not. But you'd be pretty stupid to argue it doesn't exist in the first place. And they're going to say, hey, I don't care what you say. It is, and it obviously exists. I'm standing on it. All right, so maybe that's the truth right there. That truth is actually what God is. God is the truth or the will of the people. God is the mandate of heaven. God is the voice of the collective consciousness between all of us. God is the point where we all arrive at a common unified vision and goal. We are all aware of things in a totality. God is when we make our own immutable laws for ourselves so that we can have social glue and hold ourselves together and make the world a better place for our kids. That is the power. That is the God. That is what it is for us, maybe, huh? Or no, that doesn't exist either? Okay, I can see. Okay, well, that is not the truth, of course. And so if God is truth, it's all just perspective, right? God can be whatever we want it to be. So maybe for some people, God is also beauty. That's why they make the art. That's why we have the experience. You want to feel good, right? God is the love. You want to have the love. You got to have the release of the endorphins. That's going to come from experiencing beauty. Isn't that what you love? You all love beauty. God is beauty. God is love. God is truth. God is everything. Oh. No. Beauty doesn't exist either, right? Because it's all just a perspective. But like I said, God is whatever we want it to be. Oh, no. It's not that either. It's only some white dude riding on a cloud, and that doesn't exist, so don't even use the word. Instead of setting yourself up as the person who acknowledges that thing in order to say, it does not exist. If it doesn't exist, it doesn't exist. And if people feel that God is all of these other things, and they use the concept, they use the word, they use the term, they want to describe it, then they are doing that whether you want them to or not. And that's what I come down to right now. God is a practice. God is a practice. God is something people do. And people are doing it all the time. So whether you want to acknowledge that people are doing it all the time and that it's very real to them and that it's affecting them and it's part of their lives and that it affects them socially and that it affects them with physical forms that they fucking put their heart and soul into making artistically and that affects the fucking way that they come up with the technology and the engineering skill to make those physical forms in the first place, God is not the total awareness of all people. It's not the consciousness of the universe. It's not the ability to process information that has been infused into our central nervous system. It's not the inner heart, inner mind, inner link. It's not anything. Oh, yeah, all right. Well, then what are all those other things? They don't exist or they do? Well, if other people feel that those things are their God, and that's what they call it, then you can't tell them, hey, you can't call it that. I don't like that word because it only means something stupid to me, and I don't like stupid stuff, so I just say it doesn't exist. Man, I do that too. I'll tell you, that's life. Some people will say God is life. I'll tell you, this is life. I don't believe in certain things. I don't believe in time, but I have to have it. I don't believe in money. I don't believe in this shit. I hate it, but it's still there. Oh, man, I don't believe in a lot of stuff. I don't believe in death. Oh, except it's going to happen to me. But the reason I don't believe in death is because I don't believe that death is equal to life. I believe that God is life and God is death. And that those two things are not equal because God is also birth. God is being cast into experience. It is coming into being so that you might experience this thing called life. This thing called being. This thing called Atman, where the Allah Brahma comes into being and experiences itself firsthand through the universe. Yeah. That it's born, that it lives, that it dies. God is birth, God is death, God is life. God is change. God is change. God is the movement, the evolution. God is time, and I said, I don't even believe in time. So now I'm wrapped up in my own paradox. Oh shit, I see where you guys are now. You must be tripping. And you're going to be stumbling all over yourselves to get this figured out. And let me tell you, you can bring Dawson, Tykens, Hitchens, fucking Hawking, whoever. Bring them all. Bring all the best. Bring all the theorists. Bring all the people who know. Because guess what? Jesus, children of America, he's missing know-it-all, and I'll be loving you always. Partying on the mothership. I am the mothership connection. God is now, and this is none and all. And that's what God is, baby. None and all. Zero first, everything second. I done came down here to save you. Come with me. We going on.